Hey bitches, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video, I am going to talk to you about Manny MUA receiving backlash over on Twitter because of his interview he did with Good Morning Britain. If you have not already seen my video from yesterday about Jeffree Star coming for a self-promoting fan, as well as a little bit of James Charles and Jenna Marbles drama, I am going to place a card in the upper right-hand corner, as well as a link down in the description. If this is your first time on my channel, hello, welcome, how the fuck are you doing? If you could please hit the subscribe button down below, I would greatly appreciate it. And if you are someone who has been here for a day, a week, a month, or a year, welcome the fuck back. If you could please make sure you have all of your notifications set to on by clicking the bell icon somewhere on the screen. Please know that everything I speak on in my videos is my own personal opinion. Opinions are not facts. And please do not send any hate to anyone or any brand that I speak on in my videos, because that is not what these are meant for. They are just meant for us to spill a little tea, throw a little shit, and have a messy ass time here on the internet. Earlier today, Good Morning Britain invited Manny MUA on to talk about the men in makeup movement, and here is a clip from that.
The fun part about it is that, like, I feel like makeup is for everyone. You know, everyone, and whether you're a boy, girl, anyone in between, I think makeup is truly for anyone that wants to wear it. You know, and it doesn't have to be as, you know, loud as my makeup necessarily. You know, if you want to cover up a pimple, if you want to wear some concealer to cover up some darkness, you want to wear some bronzer on, you know, a really rainy day, like, that's just kind of how makeup works. You know, you don't have to, you know, conform to any rules. You do not need to wear lashes when you're wearing makeup, you know? So I feel like if you just take what applies to you, what you really, really like, then why not use it? And that goes for literally anyone. So for me, I like to be able to go out just on a normal day, do a little bit of mascara, a little bit of concealer. But days like this where I'm like, I want to be full glam, I want to feel it, I want to get into my fantasy, you know, it's just a different vibe. So I think that anyone really can wear anything they want.
As Manny's interview was airing, Good Morning Britain tweeted out the following. Whether you're a boy, girl, anyone in between, I think makeup is truly for anyone. At MannyMUA733. The beauty blogger at the forefront of the male makeup movement says why not use it? It can help men freshen their appearance and boost self-confidence. As to be expected, when a man in makeup appears on television, it is always mixed criticism that they receive. Someone tweeted out the following. I remember the good old days when men were men and women were women, and dressed accordingly, such a happy time. Another person said the following. Men look disgusting in women's makeup. If it's a choice, which should be considered normal, why is there so much effort to push it in the faces of people who don't have time to care? They have too much time on their hands. Maybe do something worthwhile with your life. Obviously, the person that left that comment about doing something worthwhile with your life does not know how social media works, and they obviously don't know who Manny MUA is, and that is fine. But on the interview, as it's playing, underneath Manny, it says, Manny has 4.6 million Instagram followers and 5 million YouTube subscribers. I am pretty sure, even though that Manny MUA has been in a lot of drama over the last year, he is doing something extremely worthwhile with his life. Another person said the following, such a handsome boy. Yet he has to spoil his good looks with all that crap on his face. I'm struggling to remember if I was ever that bad when I was young. Nope. Manny responded to that person and said the following. I stopped reading after Handsome Boy. But of course, amongst all of the negative, and trust me, there was a lot of negative underneath that Good Morning Britain post, there was some good that came out of it. Someone tweeted to Manny and said the following. Thank you for standing up and saying there's nothing wrong with it. My son has worn makeup for a few years, and to be honest, does it better than most girls. To all the haters, fuck you. Manny responded to that and said the following. Graham, you're a wonderful father. Your son is so lucky to have you. I always find it hilarious when someone gets a stick up their ass and tries to make a point and say something derogatory about a man wearing makeup. How soon we forget that back in the day, the Egyptians were wearing makeup, men were powdering their faces, wearing those wigs that had powder in them. You guys know those judge wigs they used to wear back in the day? Oh my god, those seemed like they were so fucking itchy. But also, let's not forget the glam rock era, where people like Dee Snider, David Bowie, and all of those other musicians were wearing full-on glam. First of all, bitch, if a man or a woman takes the time to actually sit down every day and put on a full beat, you have to have some level of respect for them, because girl, I know for a fact, I do not have the patience to sit there and try to get all that stuff on my face. But also, I'm pretty sure that everyone that has a comment to say about a man in makeup loves watching TV, has a favorite actor. They probably watch a lot of movies as well. Guess what? The people that are doing those movies and are on TV, you know what they have on their face? They have makeup on. Oh my god, the fucking horror. And obviously, if you're sitting online to comment about what someone is wearing on their face makeup-wise or the clothing that they are wearing as well, then don't sit there and try to tell them to do something worthwhile with their life, because obviously you are doing nothing with yours, because you are taking the time to go onto a Twitter post where somebody was invited onto a news station to do an interview about men in makeup and comment something derogatory. So bitch, take your own advice and get out of the house. What is your opinion about the comments that people are making about Manny MUA appearing on TV and talking about men in makeup? Let's be honest, even if you are someone who is not a big fan of makeup and you don't have a lot of makeup yourself, we all have days where we could use a little bit of concealer under our eyes or we need to cover up a pimple. So there is obviously nothing fucking wrong with it, and there are people just having small-minded opinions. Topics like this always make me go back to my statement of, why do people care so much about what someone has on their face or what they're putting into their face or what plastic surgery they're having? As long as at the end of the day they're happy and they feel good about themselves, then why the fuck do you care? Manny MUA got a gag over on everyone yesterday because he uploaded a video called It's Hard to Say Goodbye. In the thumbnail, it looks like he's crying. I have to applaud Manny because when I saw that title, I was like, ooh, bitch, what's the fucking tea? And I clicked on the video immediately. And if you have not seen the video, then here is a spoiler for you. Manny MUA is moving from the house that he has had and he is going somewhere new. So he is starting a new chapter. Now, a lot of people in the comments and over on Twitter are accusing him of clickbaiting the title just to try and get views. But I don't see that as clickbait because, bitch, it is hard, one, to move. I cannot stand moving at all. But sometimes you love the place that you live in and you don't want to say goodbye, but there's either a better place somewhere out there for you, or you are ultimately forced to have to move. So I do wish Manny the best in his future endeavors wherever the hell he is moving. I'm sure it is somewhere fabulous. But what is your thought? Do you think that Manny MUA clickbaited his title, or do you think that it's not clickbait and honestly it is hard to say goodbye when you have to move from somewhere? Please let me know your thoughts down below. And now, can we just talk briefly about this Lady Gaga and Bradley Cooper thing that is taking over Twitter and all social media since the Oscars? Ever since Lady Gaga and Bradley Cooper performed their hit song Shallow from A Star Is Born on the Oscars, the internet has been going crazy and trying to say that Lady Gaga and Bradley Cooper need to get together because they are quote-unquote in love. Personally, I find it extremely rude to even start a hashtag of Lady Gaga and Bradley Cooper together because he, in fact, is in a relationship with his baby's mother. Now, some people on Twitter would throw up the argument that, oh, well, he's not married to her, so it is still fair game until she has a ring on her finger. I'm a little confused on that logic because think about if you're in a relationship. If the internet as a whole, or just a group of people in your hometown or anywhere, all of a sudden starts trying to put your boyfriend, your girlfriend, whoever you're with someone else and say, oh my god, he should leave who he's with, he should get with them because obviously they're in love, don't you think that you would be a little fucking bothered by that and you would be upset? Now think about how upset you would be in your town that you live in if people were doing that to your relationship, but think about how annoying it probably is for his baby's mother, Irina, with the fact that this is trending worldwide and there is no way to get away from it. Another thing that I find really rude and hypocritical is the fact that everyone is telling Bradley Cooper and Lady Gaga to get together, but these are the same people that were outraged when Tristan Thompson cheated on Khloe Kardashian again with Kylie Jenner's best friend, Jordan Woods. Well, Lady Gaga has made an attempt to try to dispel all of the rumors that, one, they have been hooking up during filming, but also that they are in love. On Jimmy Kimmel Live, she said the following, "I'm an artist, and guess we did a good job. We fooled you." I mean, obviously Bradley Cooper and Lady Gaga are both geniuses when it comes to the art form that is acting. That's why that movie has won so many frickin' awards. I think we should also remember how upset people were when Brad Pitt left Jennifer Aniston and decided to get with his co-star Angelina Jolie. I mean, do you guys remember those tabloids from back in the day? People were outraged. Can we please not have another situation like that? And who knows? Maybe in the future, if Bradley Cooper and Lady Gaga are both single, they will end up getting together. We don't know. But I just think it's really tacky and really rude to try to start that trend online and say, you need to leave her to get with her because, girl, you wouldn't like it happening to you at the end of the day, so I'm sure other people do not like it happening to them. What is your opinion about the whole Lady Gaga and Bradley Cooper fiasco that is going on the internet right now with people saying they need to get together? Do you find it rude? Do you find it tacky? Do you not care? Or do you just stay off of Twitter? Because you know, so many people are starting to say down in the comments that they actually do not use Twitter anymore because it has turned into such a toxic place for people to go. Please let me know all of your thoughts and opinions on Manny Imuwe's Good Morning Britain interview from earlier today, as well as him being accused of clickbait over his title about him moving, and also let me know all of your thoughts and opinions about the Oscars, Bradley Cooper, and Lady Gaga and their performance of Shallow. Do you like that song? Are you over that song? Because I've been hearing it literally everywhere. With that said, that is it for this video, everyone. I hope that you did enjoy it. As I said, please let me know all of your thoughts and opinions down below, and please follow all my social media that's down in the description. I love you guys, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!